Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So our today's topic is convex hull using Gram scan. So before understanding Gram scan, let's understand what basically is convex hull. Convex hull, as according to its standard definition, convex hull of a set Q of points is the smallest convex polygon P for which each point of Q is either on boundary of P or inside it. So let me explain this equation, or we can say definition, with the help of an example. So let's say these are the set of points which are belongs to a set Q given to us, and our task is to draw a polygon P such that all these points, they either lie on the boundary of that polygon P or inside that polygon. So here, this polygon which I have highlighted using the green marker is the convex hull. Now that's all by the convex hull and definition. Now we have to find a convex hull using the Gram scan method. So what is the Gram scan method? These are the steps which are in the Gram scan algorithm. The step number one says that find P node, which is the leftmost and the bottommost point. So we are given a set of points there, and we have to find the P node, which will be the leftmost and the bottommost point. Then for the step two is, for the remaining points, we have to sort them by the polar angle in counterclockwise around P node. So we have to make P node our x-axis, okay, and for the remaining points we have to sort them by the polar angle. Step 3, take a stack S and it should be an empty one. Step 4, push P0, P1 and P2 starting 3 points into those stack. And the step 6 says that for 3 to n, for the since we have put the starting 3 points into the stack, then for the remaining points, if my PI point, or the point I'm considering right now, is to the left of the top of the stack, the point I have on the top of the stack, if my PI is on the left of that stack top, then we can push PI into the stack. Else it says that we have to pop the top of the stack. Then finally, push PI into the stack, and in last step is we have to return the stack itself. So I think you guys will better understand it with the help of an example. So let's say we have this random set of points given to us, okay, and the first step, as by the Gram scan algorithm, was to determine the leftmost and the bottommost point. So among all these points given to us, I can see that, or we all can see that, this one is the leftmost and the bottommost point. So we have to make it P0, or I'm simply writing it 0. So if we have to draw an x-axis along that line, and we have to make that point our x-axis. Now, for the remaining point, that is the step 2, we have to sort them according to the polar angle in counterclockwise direction. So for doing that, what you guys can do is place your ruler as along the x-axis made by the P0, and then start directing it in the anti-clockwise direction. As I am directing it, I can see that this point has the lowest and counterclockwise angle. So basically this is going to be my one, P1, then this point becomes a P2, then I am rotating it and I can see that this point is my P3 and this is my P4. Similarly, this point has more angle than the P4, and this has more than P5, and this has the largest angle and becomes a P7. So my step 1 is done and my step 2 is done basically. Now my next step is that I have to take an empty stick. So let me take an empty stick S. Okay. And next step was to push P0, P1 and P2 into the stack. So pushing basically means that I have to make a polygon using P1, then using P2. Okay, so now this is my polygon which I have considered till yet. Now I have to do is, I have to consider the next point in the order, that is a P3, and I have to see whether it's on the left or right of the top of the stack. My top of the stack is P2. So how we figure out that my next point is on the left or right, what would you guys do is, we take a ruler like this and I start directing it. Look, when I extend this line from this extent, I can see that my P3 is on the right of this line. So it means that the P3 is on the right from the top of the stack. Hence, the algorithm says that I have to pop the top of the stack. Now my top of the stack becomes P1. So I will discard this line, and so my polygon will be only this one. So from the P1, I can see that when I extended this line, and I can see that, and I have to figure out again the direction of P3 as along this line. I'm extending it, and when I start rotating it, I can see that the point P3 is lying onto the left of this line P0, P1. So hence I can say that the point P3, this is how we guys do it basically. When we extend this line and when we start rotating it, here in this case, when I was rotating this line, it was coming out to be, P3 was coming out to be on the right of this line. So here when I extended this line and started rotating it, this point P3 comes out onto the left of this line. So hence I can consider P3 into my stack. Now on top of stack becomes a P3, or I can make a new stack and which looks like 0, 1 and 3. So now my polygon will look like this. Discarding the P1, 2, I have P0, P1 and P3 in my set. Now the next point is P4. Similarly, I have to do this. I have to figure it out the direction of P4. When I extend this line and I see that when I start rotating it, I see that it's going into the right direction. It's going in this direction, which is the right direction. If it has gone in this direction, that will be the left direction. This is the right. I am rotating in right direction. So hence it means that I have to discard the top of the stack. So now my top of stack is again P1. So from this line, I can see that this is extended version. And when I rotated this line, the P4 will lie onto the left, because this is the left one and this will be the right one. Okay, this is the left one. Okay, so it's P4 is lying on the left of this P1. So I will push P4 into the stack. So my new stack will become 0, 1 and 4. So now my polygon will look like P0, 1 and 4. Okay, P0, 1 and 4. Now for the next point is P5. I can see that when I extended this line, P4, and I'm seeing that my P5, I can see that very clearly. For P5, I have to rotate my line into the left hand side, on the inner side. So this is my left hand side. So I can take P5 into the stack too. That's cool. Now my polygon will look like this. So my next step point is P6, this P6. On extending the P4 and P5, I can see that my P6 lies on the left hand side of this line. So hence I can also push in P6. Look, if you pop only if the point is on the right, else you just push it into the stack. So here my P6 will also be onto the stack. Now when I extend this line, I can see that my 7 lies onto the right hand side. I have to read my line like this. It's on the right hand side. Hence I have to pop P6. Now consider this point from the top of the stack again. So top of stack is P5. Here when I extended this line, I can still see that my P7 is on to the right of P5. So I have to again discard my top of the stack. My top of the stack becomes a P4. Now when I extended this line, like the line is going like this. Okay, line is going like this. I can still see that this is how my line will extend it up. And I can see that my P7 is again lying on the right of 7. So I will have to discard the top of the stack. Now top of stack becomes a P1. Now my P1 was like this. Okay, now as I can see that P7 lies onto the left of P1. So hence I can push in P7. So 0, 1 and 7. Now the polygon will look like, I will discard all the points in between. My polygon will contain 0, 1 and 7. 0, 1 and 7. Now there's no other point left, only 0 is left. And I can see that this is how we verify this algorithm. When my last point is onto the left from the last point on the top of the stack. So here my polygon got finally complete. So basically up here, this top of in the last step, we have to return the S, and this my S tells about the points that we have considered up here. So finally my convex hull will be containing 0.0, P1 and P7. It means it will contain all the points in between, like P6, P5, P4, P2, P1. They all lies inside this convex polygon. But this P0, P1, P7, they are on the boundaries of convex polygon. And this, the last highlighted one, which I'm highlighting right now, P0, P1, P7. This is the our convex hull. Okay, guys. So this is how we find convex hull using the Gram-Schenn algorithm. Thank you.